A new art exhibit at Mesa Community College explores the future matriarchs of the Black community and includes the works of 10 Black female artists. And to learn more, we welcome Mesa Community College artist-in-residence Antoinette Cauley, who curated the exhibit, along with one of the featured artists, Ryan Johnson. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
You bet. Antoinette, future matriarchs.
Yes.
Explain, please.
So I am the current artist in residence at Mesa Community College, and they approached me because they were having an exhibition called Matriarchs of Washington Park that explored a group of Black women who lived in a segregated neighborhood in Mesa. They asked me to contrast that show with an exhibition of my own that represents the present and the future. So I came up with Future Matriarchs to explore the future of our community.
And the artists you chose, did you choose artists or
did
you choose artworks?
I chose artists and I chose works with the school, so we collaborated on that piece.
What were you looking for?
I was looking for Black women who were not afraid to use their voice, who would come in and be bold and unapologetic, and who had something powerful to say. I wanted diversity in what they were saying.
And as far, and we're kind of taking a look at some of the examples here. Uh-huh. What do you want people to take from the exhibit?
Oh, I want people to not only see our struggles as a community, because a lot of these pieces talk about different social political issues the Black community struggles with. I want them to see our strength, our resilience, and our beauty, because two things can be true at once.
Ryan, what got you interested in all this?
Well, how I got interested in art in general was my grandpa. My grandpa was an artist, so my family likes to joke that it went through generations and it went through me. But when I was younger, I saw this watercolor painting that he had done, and it was a basketball player, and he was making a shot, and it looked so, to my young mind, it was so realistic that I couldn't believe that he did it. And that inspired me to start doing art. So I started in my room just drawing little things, and it kind of eventually came to humans. And then at some point I strictly was like, oh, I'm only doing drawing. And my mom was like, one day you're gonna do painting. And then I did. I ended up doing paintings.
And was there a time when you said, you know what, I'm pretty good at this? I'm just not doodling around here.
At some point, I realized I was like, I can do something with this, you know? And my mom put me in art school, and then I just kind of continued doing that.
I want to take a look at some of your work. I think we have a couple of them here. There we go. It is one of them. Talk to us about this piece.
So that piece is part of a trio that I made, and it's called Stretched. And it's the last one in the series, and it kind of goes in order, and this one's the last one. And it's kind of about being an overachiever, but also taking on so much at the same time that you feel that burn.
Yes.
Like you feel burnt out. And that's what I was feeling my junior year when I started the series. I was taking on a lot of stuff. I was working on college, I was working on my art career, and it was kind of starting to bubble up. And it started as this first piece, it's felt very dark, and you kind of you kind of feel very dark, and you're trying to build up and it feels terrible. And then this next one's kind of I'm kind of okay now. And then this last one's okay, everything's finally over.
Yeah.
I feel and I kind of did flowers and kind of the yellow to feel like spring, you're finally over. But the piece is called And the Cycle Begins Again, because after spring, it just continues.
Yeah.
And it's kind of overachievers. They will always take on a lot. They will just continue doing that.
We have another piece of yours as well. And I wanted to explain this one do we have that one up and ready? There we go. What are we looking at here?
So this piece, I did this for a class in college, and it was, we had to do a political piece, and this is something I'm very passionate about and always have been. It's about police brutality, and I want to kind of express it through, there's this old piece called The Creation of Adam by Michelangelo, and it's a piece between Adam and God, but it's, to me, this one I kind of wanted to create in a way where police are people supposed to be people that that we're supposed to look up to, but for the Black community, that's always kind of been kind of hard to do. And they're the only people to call when you're you need help sometimes. So that's kind of what this piece is about.
Antoinette, this is the kind of thing you were looking for, wasn't it?
Yes, yes. I was looking for people who were gonna use their voice. And what I love about having Ryan in the show is she's actually our youngest artist in the show. So I feel like she is a huge and wonderful representation of the future of our community.
And as far as the exhibit is concerned, Mesa Community College?
Yes, Mesa Community College, the art gallery. The last day is actually this Monday. So people have to skedaddle down there.
And have you got something in the works here after this?
Oh, yes. I actually have a solo exhibition at MCC that will be in the fall. So I'll share that as it comes closer.
And Ryan, last question goes to you. Is this a career? Is this what you're going to do for the rest of your life, do you
think? Absolutely.
And exhibits like this, I would think, kind of spur that on, don't
they? Yes, of course.
Yeah. Well, congratulations to both of you. Antoinette Cauley, again, good to see you again. You've been on the show numerous times.
Yes.
Good to see you back. And Ryan, maybe we'll have you back as well. Congratulations on your success. Thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you.